Coming to you live, it's the hottest, loudest, most dangerous television show on the planet. Pull up a chair, pop open that beer, and get yourself ready. Everybody, come on in. It's time for Tommy's Garage! With your host, Tommy Adkins. Your mechanics, Rosie Rosencrantz. Houston comedian and filmmaker Joey Tirado. And the Chocolate Thunder himself, Gavin Babineau. With special guests, Houston comedians Mike Rao and Tim Mathis. I'm Matthew, the voice Gidry. Welcome to Tommy's Garage!
With politics. Yeah, we have two good stories right here in Texas. But first, Mark Zuckerberg, one of the richest people on earth. He runs Facebook. This is what he said at the Harvard commencement speech.
How about stopping climate change before we destroy the planet? Asking volunteers to share their health data, track their health data, and share their genomes.
Oh yeah, that's what I want to do.
We should explore ideas like universal basic income to make sure that everyone has a cushion to try new ideas.
Yeah.
Him first.
Yeah. Workers of the world unite. Yeah, Mark Zuckerberg is calling for a one world communist government where you all hold hands and sing Kumbaya, Rosie.
Yeah, okay. You all know that his last name is really Rockefeller, don't you?
Yeah.
Okay. So this douche nozzle talks a lot of BS, and then he builds giant walls around his filthy complex that he kicked out of people out of in Hawaii. This guy is just a deep state Marxist piece of garbage, is what he is.
Shoot the best.
Walls are terrible as long as it's not theirs.
Exactly, y'all. Well, you got three, you got two bells and a hammer in one shot.
Excellent. Yeah, you should be more clear about your positions. Anyways, I thought the great
struggle. Is this thing on?
I thought the great struggle of our time was to try to get Facebook to implode and be wiped out from the face of the earth, you know? Because, I'm not the hugest fan. But Schmuckerberg could take his moral relativism to the devil, where it came from.
Yeah!
That's right.
I know that. I knew that, dude.
God, I miss Tom from MySpace.
Is it
just me? And Tom never bothered you. He just sent you a friend request and looked creepy as hell for like the next...
Right?
That's all he did. That's all he did.
I can't disagree with that. America is so great, it's so incredible, and capitalism is so amazing that a communist college kid with his head 3 feet up his can accidentally create the seventh largest economy in the world and have no freaking idea how he got there.
Yeah.
Hey, Zuckerberg, it's called capitalism, you dumb!
Yes!
Meanwhile, in a state built upon capitalism, a bit of controversy, Black Lives Matter, and a QuantLX, and a bunch of other communist knuckleheads are trying to tear down the statue of Sam Houston. They claim he was a slave owner, and he stole land from Mexico, Rosie.
Yeah, well, this is no Confederate icon. This is the George Washington of Texas!
Yes, he is!
So what do they want to change the name of it? They want to change the name of our city also? What are they going to call it? Safe Space City?
This is another complaint from the mommy never breastfed me and daddy should have kicked me in the when I was in grade school.
Exactly.
They demand perfection from everybody else but never themselves. I think they should eat another Anthony Weiner.
I do have two history degrees, so I have to point this out. First of all, Sam Houston was not only not a Confederate icon, like you said, Rosie, he actually fought against Texas leaving to join the Confederacy.
Exactly.
Not only that, this man, Sam Houston, is an honorary member of the Cherokee Nation.
Yes!
So the question is, why are all these people so racist?
Nice!
Right there. Hey, I'm Cherokee Indian. I don't see all the Mexicans moving back to Spain. I don't see the black liberals packing their crap and moving to Africa. And I don't see white liberals staying and moving back to Europe. You're on my land! You hate my land? Leave America! Mexicans, take your 67 Chevy pickup truck with you. Black folks, leave your weed for Rosie and Tim.
Free the weed! Free the weed!
And white folks, leave your women. Oh! I know. I'm Indian. I can say that. I can say that. I'm Indian. All right. In Washington, look what happened.
I am fighting every day for the great people of this country.
Ooh, I love this guy.
Therefore, in order to fulfill my solemn duty to protect America and its citizens, the United States will withdraw from the Paris Climate Accord
that nobody adheres to.
Right.
Thank you.
That we give all our taxpayer money
That's
to.
Right. It's basically the bend over and screw America Accord. Look, Donald Trump pulled America out of the Paris Climate Agreement. Rosie, does it mean the planet will overheat into a ball of fire and spiral out of the galaxy?
Okay, Trump pulled out of the Climate Accord. The last time a president pulled out, a blue dress needed dry cleaning.
Wow. Big bell and hammer in one shot.
I guess those funless Frenchies are gonna have to eat their carbon-enriched baguettes by themselves. But anyways, if the Paris Climate Accords were a woman, a beautiful model, say Miss Universe, you know, but she was a lousy lay, I'd pull out. That's a lie.
I would not. Get out of here. You're such a liar.
Pull out.
I was just kidding.
Yeah, no, that, maybe, but I hate to see the love child. You know what I mean? Like, no.
Wish your dad had.
It is my last show, so I would be remiss if I didn't make a joke about this.
That's why I have you here, Tim.
Yes.
Yeah, I hope so.
There are three things I've learned in my time in Houston to pull out of. Number one. I'm usually pulling into Jack in the Box.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Number one is any parking space downtown that you're not sure if you can park at.
Right there.
Number two is a climate accord that only affects America.
Yes.
And number three is my ex Ashley from Lake Jackson. Which not only should you pull out immediately, you should get yourself checked the next morning.
Look, when it comes to screwing around with socialists, I always recommend pulling out. Speaking of communists, she's back. That means it's time for
Bitch Watch!
Yes, it's Bitch Watch, where Tommy's Garage keeps an eye on the worst women in the world. This week in Chappaqua.
President Bill Clinton and former Secretary of State and presidential candidate Hillary Clinton, residents of Chappaqua, led the parade alongside Governor Cuomo.
Yeah, Bill and Hillary Clinton were featured in the Memorial Day parade. There's talk about a 2021 for president, Rosie.
Yeah, a drunken, pathological, murderous, liar, sociopath running for president, right? She'll be lucky if she gets her sponsors in AA to vote for her.
Ooh, that's hammer right there.
Well, Tommy, I think you'd have seizures too if you wore fire repellent, penis repellent pantsuit 7 days a week, okay? And still lost the presidential race twice. She's blaming, I think, the spaghetti monster now.
Spaghetti monster.
That's a sucker, though.
Here's a piece of advice for Hillary. This time around, maybe you should at least visit Wisconsin one time.
Yeah, right. Exactly. Look, this might be the first time in any town in America that they honored a rapist and a murderer at the Memorial Day parade. You know, it's unbelievable. All right, by the way, this week, Barack Obama spoke up in Germany. He said building a wall is racist. So let's get the whole picture here. Yeah. Yeah, 10 feet high. Yeah. Congratulations, President Obama, you are now a racist. Matthew Gidsby, what's up next?
Next, hopefully we will build that wall.
Yeah.
That should be next. Meanwhile, while we wait, the bigot lottery and the professionals are coming up. But next, it's worldwide panic. It's Tim's going away party.
Yeah.
Only on Tommy's Garage.
locked your deadbolt. But this happened. Why? Because deadbolts do not prevent kick-ins. You need Armor City Doors. There were over 1 million kick-in robberies in 2014 alone. But when deadbolts fail, Armor City Doors protects. Guaranteed. 713-487-5539. Or stop by armorcitydoors.com. Remember, deadbolts do not stop kick-ins. But when deadbolts fail, you need Armor City Doors. ArmorCityDoors.com.
Healthcare system broken. The FDA broken. And the pharmaceutical industry is not there to help you. How can you give your body healthy, maximum performance naturally without chemicals and additives? EarthPatriots.com has found a natural solution. It's native to your body, crucial to your health. This product helps repair your cells and boosts your immune system, effectively slowing down the aging process. Stop by EarthPatriots.com.
For the most fascinating stories imaginable, and we found a few. Joining us, comedian Mike Rowe.
And Chocolate Thunder, Gavin Babineaux.
Hey, would Tommy's Garage be complete without a wiener story?
No.
Of course not. Well, here we go. Uma Abedin has finally invited Anthony Wiener back into the home. Apparently. Come on, Brandon. Can we get a better picture? Come on, like.
That's better?
No, not of him. A better picture of her. We can't get a better picture of her?
That's better. That is the better picture.
We got something. Come on, Brandon. We got something. There we go. I know. It's close. You can't tell. There we go. I guess you're right. This boat's still long. But anyway, Uma Abedin is back in the news. She's letting Anthony Wiener back in the house, Rosie.
Yeah, and Anthony Wiener will be a great vice presidential candidate for Hillary Clinton in 2020. She has extensive background working with sexual predators.
Oh!
That! And I think Wiener's nose reminds her of her camel back in Saudi Arabia.
Oh, God! That's like, oh, another hammer. God, that's awful.
I had to throw two of them in there.
First of all, I'm in the second chair. What the hell do I do?
Yeah.
Is this like, I think it's last second affirmative action.
Yes, yeah. It is.
Oh, my God.
Look at that black privilege.
So can we all agree, that she's an idiot for taking this dump back?
Yes.
I mean, just think about all the people. No. Think about all the people that he's probably screwed around with. I bet he's got so much clap, it's a standing ovation. Just like that.
Two hammers.
Just like that.
Nice.
Well, the reason that she's doing it, she says, is that she doesn't want her son to grow up without a father, and that kid needs a father because he's 5 now and he's never sent a dick pic.
Oh, no, he didn't!
Yes, he did, man.
Hey, take a good look at that face. No wonder the guy, he'd rather be thrown in jail, right? Yeah. I'd rather be in jail if I have to get home with that. Oh, my God. Meanwhile, celebrity comedian, ugly wench, whatever she is.
Oh. Wow.
Off with her
head. Kathy Griffin thought it'd be funny, huh? To hold a fake Donald Trump head covered with blood on TV. Wrong! Even liberals didn't think it was all that funny. CNN fired her, and guess who else thought it wasn't funny? The Secret Service, Rosie.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
She needs to donate blood.
Liberal communist Kathy Griffin is so desperate for a husband that decapitating Trump is her way to get ISIS and Al-Qaeda to finally answer her Tinder messages.
Ouch. Ouch.
That's mean. I love it.
Wait, that's actually...
No, that's a cleaver.
You can't call the shots. Let the man call the shots, thank you.
You know what I need? I do need a cleaver. I got to get a cleaver here.
Look, we know that she got fired. We know that she's lost a lot of paid gigs already. You know you screwed up when Squatty Potty gave you the dump, okay?
Yeah. Oh,
done.
Nice.
Ad lib, baby.
Squatty Potty.
I like Squatty Potty. I do. I mean, that's
like you would, Mike.
Yeah, as an old person. See, actually, I want you to look at this picture carefully because that's not Donald Trump's head. That's Mike Myers' head.
It is.
Yes.
See, what she's going for is she wants to be the new Mike Myers on the new remake of Halloween.
No.
More disgusting than a severed head of Donald Trump. This.
That.
There you go.
That's where that girl from The Exorcist.
There's nothing funny about that. Like they said, beauty is only skin deep, but ugly is to the bones. Yeah. Hey, how about another wiener story? What the hell, right? I got to go on for you. Watch this guy. Take a look. That is exactly what it looks like.
Oh my God.
This guy's pulling a helicopter with what? With his family jewels. Yes, Kung Fu Master Ye Hung Wei pulled a helicopter 36 feet. Rosie, this could be your chance to be famous.
Finally, Tommy's garage gets back to the wiener stories.
I love it.
So if Gavin tried that, they'd need a jumbo jet.
Yes, Gavin.
So I guess that's why they call him Numb Nuts.
Ouch.
No.
Ouch.
Is,
yeah. Ouch.
Ouch.
Ouch. Okay, so have you guys ever had a nice conversation with a cool redneck, and he just says that you ain't got the balls, son? That guy does. He really does.
No, I like this guy. Yeah, you got to read the story. He's actually pulling that with his penis. Honest to God, that is absolutely true. He's pulling it with his penis. But there's a reason. He's a kung fu master. He has a black belt, and now he's just going for the black penis, right?
I like that one.
The taffy puller wasn't getting it done. Yeah. So
maybe he's born with it. Maybe it's
Who would mess around with that guy?
I don't know.
Forget the kung fu. He's liable to pull out that Louisville slugger, smack him 6 feet away. You know. Then again, there's this guy.
That's FTD. Сейчас за серию удар Альфа. Ну, они не очень сильные, но уже совсем нет силы Кочигина, и Ян Воборник останавливает этот бой.
Yeah, the guy who lost, his name is Viktor Kachigin. He's Russian. He fights MMA style in Russia. Unfortunately, he got his beat this week by that guy. No, that guy just won the bout. The real beating happened after the fight. That's his mom. His mom beat his Watch this. She's like, his mom is Anna Asovskaya. I hear she's single, Rosie.
I just want her to teach parenting classes in all the schools in the United States of America. That way, that'll solve the snowflake problem.
I hope so.
From Russia with love,
there
baby.
You go. Yeah. That would be great. Ouch. I really think, look, I mean, that is mom of the year, dude.
Yes. I mean, yes.
Look. Casey Anthony used to have that title, but that bitch said, hold my beer, okay? Sorry. She rocks.
You're killing me.
Viktor and Anna, huh? There's a mother and son who got their steroid injections mixed up.
Yeah. Oh, yes. I'll tell you what, man. In that family, those kids take the trash out. Well, there's fighting, there's loving, so what's the best age for sex? Eh? For women, the latest survey they had says it's age 36, Rosie.
Yeah. You haven't had the cutest sex, ladies. Unless you had the Rosie man take you to heaven.
Oh.
I'm hovering over the bell. But Tommy, but seriously, I found the best way to have sex is to have a big fat wallet.
Yeah, yeah, that's a very attractive thing.
Best sex you'll ever have if you got a big,
at any
big,
age.
Big fat wallet.
So that's your secret.
Yeah.
God, it's good to be black. So. look, Tom, I only half believe this article, and after much interracial, interpersonal, investigation. Thank you, ladies.
Lots of research.
Thank you. I firmly believe the best age for sex doesn't freaking matter as long as it's with me.
Yeah, see?
That's a good
another
philosophy.
One,
yeah. I'm just getting a little nostalgic. I remember when I hit my sexual peak. I was alone. There were no witnesses. It was a beautiful night.
It was yesterday.
Actually, the article says it's anybody over 36, women over 36 hit their sexual peak. And that's true because my wife and I have been married for 36 years, actually, and we have sex twice a day.
Twice a day?
In the hallway.
Yeah. Yep.
The hallway.
No, we pass each other in the hallway, and she goes, screw you, and I go, screw you, too. That's oral sex. Twice.
Hey, you guys doing the best age for sex right now. Hey, speaking of sex, by the way, a few weeks ago, rompers for men were unleashed upon the public. We saw those, right? That was pretty gay. Now the latest lace shorts for men.
What?
Yeah, lace shorts for men. What do you guys think, everybody?
Gay.
Join me. Are you ready? Gay
ass.
There we go. All right. Matthew was sweating for us on the other side.
Why does my name just happen to follow gay ass?
It's not by design.
Hopefully not a pair of those gay shorts, Tommy. Later we have the professionals and are sending off to Tim Mathis. Did I just see him leave? But first, the Bigot Lottery, only on Tommy's Garage!
Healthcare system broken, the FDA broken, and the pharmaceutical industry is not there to help you. How can you give your body healthy, maximum performance naturally without chemicals and additives? EarthPatriots.com has found a natural solution. It's native to your body, crucial to your health. This product helps repair your cells and boosts your immune system, effectively slowing down the aging process. Stop by EarthPatriots.com.
You locked your deadbolt, but this happened. Why? Because deadbolts do not prevent kick-ins. You need Armor City Doors. There were over 1 million kick-in robberies in 2014 alone. But when deadbolts fail, Armor City Doors protects. Guaranteed. 713-487-5539. Or stop by armorcitydoors.com. Remember, deadbolts do not stop kick-ins. But when deadbolts fail, you need Armor City Doors. ArmorCityDoors.com.
We are back!
Yeah!
It's time to play the Bigot Lottery.
Boom, boom, boom.
Boom, boom, boom.
It's the Bigot Lottery. I hope that doesn't look like me.
The biggest idiots who do the dumbest things, and then we force ourselves to guess the race of the idiot and us embarrassing everybody in the process. Joining us is the lovely Brittany Lee.
Brittany Lee!
Thank you.
Hey, Matthew, let's see that scoreboard, buddy.
All right, we got Rosie holding fast at 5.
We I like holding everything fast.
I bet you do.
And he does, apparently.
Flamer.
Except for Matt Guidry.
Ooh.
Brittany's got 3 thus far. Gavin has managed to catch Rosie in more ways than 1 with 5.
I don't want
to
know those other ways.
Yeah, I'm so
no,
privileged.
No. Oh, no, I didn't.
I said
Tom, are you ready? Are
yeah!
You ready?
Yeah.
Are you guys ready to play Bigger Lottery?
Yeah!
In Florida.
White.
South Teen America.
Oh. I'm not going there.
A woman was arrested for prowling. When they were booking her, they hit her with an additional narcotics charge. Did they find drugs in her car? No. In her purse? No. In her pocket? No. Pretty much only one place left to look. They found a glass crack pipe up her $2,750 bail. White, black, Hispanic, or Asian? Rosie.
Well, you know, you would think white on this one, but.
Yeah? Well?
Audience.
White.
You're going to the audience already?
Yeah, I'm
yeah, they're really helping you a lot, Rosie.
Every time I do that, I get nowhere.
Sometimes.
Okay, I'm going to go black on this one.
Rosie goes black.
Oh.
Mother, shut your mouth.
Well, I'm gonna say for Snoochie Babuchis, we're gonna go black here. Yeah.
Oh, 2 blacks. Gavin, are you gonna like continue the trend here, or are you gonna do a buck the trend?
Well,
look,
no, hold on. I know we don't know. At least I sure as hell don't know.
Well, that's the whole point.
So, to honor the dearly departed, I'm gonna say Hispanic.
Oh! Whoa!
Here. It's all over the place. Let's meet our lady with a secret stash and her stinky Lori Shanks, she is back!
Yeah!
Yes, no more hide and go seek for you, lady. Somewhere in America, a mama wanted to go shopping, but she had her kids with her, 2 years old and 5 years old. And everybody knows what a pain kids can be, right?
Oh.
Right? So she did what any other mother would do. She locked the kids in the trunk of the car.
Oh, nice!
And she went shopping, and the one hit you're gonna get here is at Walmart.
Wow.
Fortunately, some shoppers walked by the car and heard the crying and talked to the kids, and they got them to pull that little trunk release thing. A child welfare agency has been contacted. White, black, Hispanic, or Asian, Rosie.
Oh, my God. This was somewhere in the world?
I'm not telling you where, but Walmart's the first hit you're gonna get.
So Walmart locked kids in a trunk. It's got to be Saltine American. That's got to be a cracker doing that.
Saltine American.
That's got to be my people doing that. Saltine American.
I was going to go Asian, but it's Walmart, so I don't see a lot of Asians in Walmart. I'm going to go with Saltine American.
Oh, it's 2 for Saltine American, Gavin.
Yeah.
I mean, it's freaking Walmart. I have to go Saltine American.
Yeah!
Oh, wow, so now, what do you guys think out here? Lion's steak. Let's meet our nurse scratcher mama, Tony.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah.
She's white, right?
She's white.
I got 2 already.
Woo! We're
in
winning.
Florida.
White.
A man was arrested for stealing from Spencer's Gifts. Now, if you know anything about Spencer's, they tend to carry some exotic items.
Yeah.
You know, things you might find in daddy's bottom drawer.
Do they need a lot of batteries?
Oh, yeah. In this case, maybe a pervert's nightstand. I don't know. Yes, he was caught stealing a super sucker toy.
Oh.
From the Doc Johnson collection.
Oh.
It says on the package, our super sucker is ideal for guys that need extra stimulation to satisfy their cravings.
Oh, nice.
Oh, we already know.
How late did they open tonight?
Explain further or we'll never get out of the show. Is our monkey spike and shoplifter white, black, Hispanic, or Asian?
Asian.
I'm going to Gavin on this one.
Oh, he's passing off to Gavin. Gavin.
I'm going to go for the not so obvious and good.
Asian?
What? They wouldn't be able to fit it in the damn toy. So, no. I'm going to say Hispanic.
Wow. Hispanic.
I was going to go Asian, but I'm not, you know, I don't think that it's necessarily, I've seen Asians with larger so I'm going to go with Hispanic because
I'm not asking any questions. No questions.
I mean,
no.
Stereotype, okay. Like Elgin.
I don't want to know.
So where are you going here?
I'm going Hispanic. Hispanic.
Hispanic, Rosie, you, what do you think?
Well, he went Hispanic, she went Hispanic.
Asian.
I don't want to get left out. I'm going to go Hispanic, too.
Well, yeah. What do you guys think out here? Let's meet our super sucker, Alejandro Marcelo Perez.
Yeah.
Yes, he is Hispanic. What the hell, one more, right?
One more? Why not? One more.
All right, this one's going to be fun. Everybody knows colleges have nutty liberals, right?
Yeah.
Well, a dean at a famous college has become famous for teaching cultural sensitivity. But she was busted. For what? For getting the ballot the statue of Hillary Clinton? No. Mistaking a lesbian for a man? No.
Oops.
Not screaming loud enough at the white male privilege protest? No. Okay. She was busted for going on Yelp. She was raiding restaurants by making racist insults and assaulting poor people. The head of her college placed her on leave. So there are two parts to this one. First is our insensitive liberal college dean, Indian dot, Pakistani or Asian, Rosie.
She's the head of the college?
She's a dean.
A dean?
At this college.
A liberal dean.
It's a, well, yeah, at a college.
Asian.
Rosie goes Asian, Brittany Lee.
Ooh, that's hard. I think I'm gonna go with
that's
Indian
what
Dot.
She said.
Indian Dot.
Yeah.
Gavin.
I kind of like Indian Dot, but I'm gonna go different and say Pakistani. Just
to ooh, keep it going. Three different choices. What do you guys think out here? Let's meet our snotty liberal racist hypocrite. Wait, that doesn't exactly narrow it down, does it? But this will narrow it down, especially when you look into her narrow little chink eyes. Meet Choo Choo.
Rosie's on fire tonight.
Our slanty-eyed devil is writing reviews complaining about white trash, poor people, and people who aren't rich and refined like she is. But for 2 points, what college did this racist hypocrite teach at?
Harvard!
Yale, which produced such liberal criminals as Bill and Hillary Clinton, John Kerry, and George Bush.
Makes sense.
Did I say that? I did. Harvard, which produced such dim bulbs as Matt Damon, and of course the all-time king of Barack Obama.
Oh my God, yes!
Rice University, which shamefully graduated just dopes as press secretary Josh Earnest and former Houston mayor Anise Parker.
Oh God.
Damn, or the San Jose Community College, who I never heard of until now.
California.
Yale, Harvard, Rice, or the San Jose Community College, Rosie?
It's Yale.
Woo! Yale, Rice, Harvard, or San Jose? It's got to be San Jose City College.
Rosie goes San Jose City College. Brittany.
Yeah, I think so. I think they're going with a cheap version of
California. It's California.
It's got to be California. San Jose City College, yeah.
Gavin, what do you think, buddy? This is for 2 points. There's a lot at stake here.
I know. I'm going to have to go San Jose.
Yeah,
wow. California. What do you guys think out here?
Yale.
Who thinks it's Yale? Who thinks it's Harvard?
I'm alone with my
what? Nobody. Who thinks it's Rice? Who thinks San Jose City College?
Yeah!
Let's see the famous liberal college that offers advanced degrees of snotty leftist hypocrisy. It's Yale!
Yeah!
Yes. June Chu has now achieved a level of spectacular shame previously held by 2 former presidents and 1 blind bitch in a pantsuit. And she now moved Yale underneath the average community college when it comes to class and civility. Pretty good.
Much.
Well, at least she doesn't wear pants, so we'll give her that. All right, that wraps up the bigot lottery. Matthew, how do we do, man? How do we do?
We've got Rosie at 9.
Yeah!
Woo! Brittany at 6.
Woo!
And Gavin has come up to 7. So
wow.
Pretty tight race.
I missed an episode.
Way to be, Rosie.
So do Z. All right. How'd you guys do out here?
Pretty good.
2? How'd you do?
4?
Who had 4? Who had 3? That's pretty good, man. I mean, who had 2? You got 2, right?
It's so great.
All right, pretty good. We have a good crowd here tonight. All right. So, Matthew. Hey, buddy. Tell me what's going on next.
Well, Tommy, next up, it's a professionals. By the way, I had 9 points, most possible.
Yeah.
And then we give the big kiss off to Timmy. See you in 60 seconds. It's Tommy's Garage.
Woo!
locked your deadbolt. But this happened. Why? Because deadbolts do not prevent kick-ins. You need Armor City Doors. There were over 1 million kick-in robberies in 2014 alone. But when deadbolts fail, Armor City Doors protects. Guaranteed. 713-487-5539. Or stop by ArmorCityDoors.com. Remember, deadbolts do not stop kick-ins. But when deadbolts fail, you need Armor City Doors. ArmorCityDoors.com.
Healthcare system broken. The FDA broken. And the pharmaceutical industry is not there to help you. How can you give your body healthy, maximum performance naturally without chemicals and additives? EarthPatriots.com has found a natural solution. It's native to your body, crucial to your health. This product helps repair your cells and boosts your immune system, effectively slowing down the aging process. Stop by EarthPatriots.com.
Professionals.
Yeah.
Yes, yes, yes. Yes, Tommy's Garage invites three guests from the Houston entertainment scene and attempts to ruin their careers in less than 6 minutes. Joining us is comedian Mike Rao. Another wiener story.
No.
Absolutely. It's a week of wieners. A week of wiener. What the hell? Hey, remember that guy 2 weeks ago who choked his girlfriend to death and claimed he did it with his wiener?
Yes.
Guess what, Mike? He got off.
Really? Well, I'm sorry, but if this is true, this is the second time he got off by choking her.
Oh. Whoa, man. That's
clever. Well, what, what's the guy going to use? A small penis defense? That never works.
Yeah.
You can ask Greg Hatt about that one.
Oh!
Yes! Wow.
Bring I only have a couple.
Yeah, attack the audience. That's a good way to keep the show
going. No, he's a special member.
This is actually not a joking matter. There is actually, no, I'm serious. The CDC has actually released a warning because there's too many women having sex with guys with too big a penis. They say it's basically correlated to how many comedians you sleep with. So a simple rule of thumb, ladies, if the magnum is too snug, just give it a tug.
That's a good fellow. I like that one. Right. Like, if having a wiener, a big wiener is a crime, I'm doing like hard time. Do I just say
can
that?
We give him a bomb?
Ah, come on.
You knew it was coming. Oh, we got a double. Brandon has spoken, Tommy.
Well, speaking of big wieners, Tiger Woods was arrested for DUI. Not drinking. Pain meds, Mike.
You got big wieners?
Tiger. Uber, Tiger, Uber.
Yeah.
And what's this? What is he trying out for Fat Albert and the Cosby Kids? What the hell's with the double chin? What happened to him? He looks like me.
Damn.
if you have to go golf game, you can go make a couple $100 million.
I don't know how he clears his gut.
Why doesn't this, with the kind of bank that this guy has, why doesn't he have a team of Playboy limousine drivers, you know, waiting on his beck and call to drive his blazing around whenever he wants to.
That's what
I think he needs new representation.
That's a good idea, though. I like that idea.
He's got the money for
a bunch
it.
Of naked, a bunch of naked chicks driving around all day. I can go with that.
Yeah.
Is Tiger the only black man in America that hasn't seen the movie Get Out? Listen. Nothing bad happened until he started banging those Waffle House hoes. Yeah. Tiger, get out of Florida. No, well, probably.
You know?
If he drove through Lake Jackson, he banged her.
She was on the side of the road. She was on the side, right?
What happened?
Hey, Ashley, this is why you don't date a guy who does television.
Ever.
Just say no.
No, you can date guys on TV. Just don't sleep with everybody in town.
The other piece of advice, right? Forget those four back surgeries he went through. Tiger Woods is taking pain meds for the $500 million his ex-wife stole out of ripped out of his wallet. That's what
that's millions.
Yeah, I don't know how it's a lot. In Boise, Idaho, a man was rushed to the hospital. Car accident?
Yep.
Fell from like a ladder or something? No. Terminal herpes? No. He got a fidget spinner stuck up his
mic.
Look, we've all been there before. Wait. No, come on now. You're lying naked on the bed, you're bored, and you go, gee, you know, I wonder what a miniature lawnmower would feel like shoved up my ass. And this guy answered it for us, and for that, he's a hero.
Get another bell, too. That's three bells.
All right, let's analyze this first, okay? Why would anybody put one of those fidget spinners up your rectum?
Something tells me you have an answer.
Because Matt Guidry will do it for free.
That's not true. But
you're on.
Oh no, you didn't.
I did. I'm sorry. I love you. It's from love. It's
got your fidget spinner right here.
Yeah. After the show.
I guess he was right after all. You're ready to go, Matt.
My favorite part of this story was his excuse. He said first he put it close to his anus to see if it would feel good. Then he put it in his anus to see if it would feel good. And somehow he went too far. He went too far when he decided to jam this thing up his That's too far.
Something tells me this was no accident. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Definitely not.
Hey, you guys, does anybody here have a secret?
I do. No.
Psychologists say everyone's keeping 13 secrets.
Yikes!
13. So, Mike?
That's a
bad
little
number.
Tell us one.
Okay.
I'm hurt, but I'll get through it. Anyways, I. Okay. One of my secrets is I don't have 13 secrets. I have like 5,000 secrets. 1,000 of which are probably on the internet in Technicolor. I'm just saying.
Do they look anything like that one?
I'm all racing. Yeah. Hey, it was good money, okay? It was good money.
That's a bell.
I do have two secrets. Number one, I am moving out to LA to do a secret project I can't talk about right now. It may not be finished for a while, but it's out there. And number two, I'm gonna miss you guys at Tommy's Garage.
Yeah. Oh, you're gonna be a waiter!
Yeah.
Look, I'll tell you one thing. If I had that spinner stuck up my that'd be one of my 13 secrets. Let's say hello to Tommy's Garage announcer, Matthew Guidry. Matthew, what's coming up next?
I have no idea, because the cue card's not there. However, I do have some advice. If you're going to stick a fidget spinner up your tie a string to it. I mean, this is not rocket surgery.
Or rocket science, right?
It's the end. We say goodbye to Timmy Matthews. Oh, stay with us. This will be fun as long as we keep our pants off. On. Only on Tommy's Garage!
Come on, dude, you're supposed to be helping me clean the pool. You're gonna get me in trouble again.
Yeah, all right, I'm coming.
Yes, it's the Bigot Lottery. Every week we scour the world to find the biggest idiots who do the dumbest things, and we force ourselves to guess.
I'm not getting in trouble because of him again. I'm getting proof he's not working. Come on, man, we gotta clean the pool.
They're shopping at Walmart, riding horses, and doing so. Look at that. Is that crazy or what?
That's right.
Yeah.
Why were you watching? That was so funny.
I was watching the Bigot Lottery on Tommy's Garage.
Dude, you just made the Bigot Lottery.
Healthcare system broken. The FDA broken. And the pharmaceutical industry is not there to help you. How can you give your body healthy, maximum performance naturally without chemicals and additives? EarthPatriots.com has found a natural solution. It's native to your body, crucial to your health. This product helps repair your cells and boosts your immune system, effectively slowing down the aging process. Stop by EarthPatriots.com.
Hi, it's me, Mike Ray, on the set of Tommy's Garage. I'm in Tommy's chair right now because I have something important to tell you. Be at the Houston Improv on July 12th, 8 p.m. for Cua Gente and Friends. Who's Cua Gente? A great national touring comic. And I'll be there along with Crystal Powell from Comedy Central and Rich Williams from BET TV, plus a whole bunch of other great comics. 8 o'clock, get your tickets online at www.HoustonImprov. Actually, no, that's ImprovHouston.com. ImprovHouston.com. Goodbye.
Yeah! Hey, everybody. Thank you for coming tonight.
Hell yeah!
This is a very special night because tonight we're saying goodbye to Tim, right?
Yes.
So Tim's heading to L.A. To answer the call of Hollywood. Yeah. Big deal. Or maybe the call of one of the Hollywood Boulevard Fletchbackers, I don't know.
Or Cher.
Regardless, Tommy's Garage must say goodbye, right? So come on.
Okay.
Come on over.
Ah.
Don't wreck the house. It's cool.
Sorry, bust.
Right here, dude. So this is this Tommy's Garage. Oh, Tommy's Garage is bidding fair. Jessica. Jessica, what are you doing, huh?
Tommy's Garage, just
want to
wish you the best in L.A. and let you know that we really support you.
Oh, all right, sit down. I got the hot chicks here right now.
Hey, I'm leaving tomorrow.
Yeah, right. So look, let's all say goodbye to Tim, right, with a few words here, right?
Yeah.
So look, I brought some old friends along. I got Sam Greaseball here, right?
Greaseball.
Yeah, whatever my word is.
Hey, you got it right in the dumpster behind Kroger's. Get it right here.
Yeah, ouch.
Wow.
Ouch.
All right, Tim, all your comic pals and Lake Jackson chipped in, and we wanted to send you a going-away present to remind you of the hole you're leaving behind. You take a good look at this because the only way a hoe is useful is if you got a handle on it.
I also have your homeless starter kit.
Oh,
it'll carry you through until you get that job at Denny's.
This is almost big enough for one bowl.
Yeah.
Okay.
So let's see who else has here. Where's Joey first? Where's Joey? Joey, say something.
I want to say something. I think it's great. I've appreciated working very closely with the great Russian writer, Fyodor Dostoevsky. your book, Crime and Punishment, didn't suck. And one thing I wanted to say, you know, Tim never claps when he's excited about something or he finds somebody extremely attractive. He has a much more cultured response. He plays with Mike Rayo's balls.
Oh! That's a good guess. Gavin.
Man, I'm going to miss you. As you all know, he and I are the two most laid-back people on the show. But he's got me beat on that damn mustache. It's so hot.
Yes, he does.
It is hot.
I'm going to miss this guy. Pound for pound, the funniest guy I think has ever been on the show.
Hey, thank you. Thank you.
I'm sorry, Rosie.
Yeah.
Nice try. He is the man.
Thank you.
He said pound for pound.
Yeah, where's that coming from?
I've been praying for you, Tim. I pray that sometime right about when you get there, you become either funny or gay so that it works out. Rosie.
Tommy, I first met Tim about a year ago, and I can remember like it was yesterday, the first thing he said to me, "Can I wash your windshield for a dollar, mister?" But Tim has a lot of trouble with women.
No,
he really does. And the last time he ever made a wet is when he drowned a bag of cats in the river.
Kind of pissed because after the show last week, I wanted one of those famous mustache rides, but I couldn't push Joey off your face.
Rosie, help you with that? I think Rosie.
Mike Rayo!
I don't know when we lost control of the show.
About 2 years ago.
Tim, hey, thanks for coming on the show. I asked Tim to join us on the show, and of course he's made me look bad ever since. I really appreciate that. And I just hope that as soon as you get out to L.A., you find the Salvation Army store so you can get a new wardrobe. In all seriousness, thanks for coming. And when you hit it big, my number is 315-657. I expect to be a guest star on your sitcom. Thank you.
There you go. That's right.
Tim, come on, buddy.
Tim, I think I speak for everybody. I wish you the very best in your California adventure. So please remember these words of good wishes as you crawl from audition to audition, work in the grimy, slimy streets of L.A., trying to scrounge a few dollars together without selling your butthole to some rich Hollywood producer who waves a couple of Benjamins in exchange for your services, you know, or in your case, maybe a couple of George Washingtons. But just remember these words of encouragement and a simple rhyme to give you a moment of smiles to help you through another miserable day in Los Angeles, okay?
All right.
May the gods of comedy smile. May millions of fans scream hooray. And may every hot chick in Hollywood ride on your mustache all day.
Thank you, everybody. Am I supposed to say something? Am I supposed to do jokes, Tim? I gotta do jokes also. I like Mike Rayo saying that I made him look bad as if he needed help. That's good. Mike Rayo has a face for radio, a voice for TV, and a body for the morgue. Gavin's not in trouble because he came to my show, so he's off the hook. Rosie Rosenkrantz is a 170-pound man in a 10-gallon hat, and he's 100% full of shit. He was very funny. Very funny first chair. Give it up for Rosie Rosenkrantz.
I learned from the best.
I didn't have to write anything, because before the show, he said out loud, "I am the king of..." That just pretty much wrote himself. I love Brittany, but every day she posts online that she does hair, and it just makes me feel bad about my situation. So there's that. When I found out I was going to be on the show, Mike Rahal asked me to be on the show, and I was going to be working with such amazing people like Rosie Rosenkrantz, Tom Atkins, Mike Rahal. But once I found out Joey Tirado was on the show, I knew for sure I would have no problem doing this. because Joey is Joey.
Yeah!
And finally, last but not least, let me just say, it's been a long, strange trip for me in Houston. When I first got here, I actually got laid off by the Lieutenant Governor Dan Patrick from a radio show. Right? I agree, 100%. Another thing is, I worked with Darby Douglas, Jennifer Reyna, but it was really exciting to work with probably the biggest name in Houston entertainment. And I would like to thank Tom Atkins. I would like to thank Tom Atkins for allowing me to work with Matthew Guidry. This was very exciting. This was very exciting. Oh my God. Thank everybody. Thank Tom. Great guy. Great show. Thank you, everybody. I'm going to be at the Dallas Hyenas the 15th through the 17th, so come out and see me. Thank you.
Hey, from all of us out to everybody out in TV land, I'm Tommy Yaggins. It's time to close the garage. We'll be back next week with another great show. So remember, pull up a chair, pop open a beer. It's time for Tommy's Garage.
Yeah!
Live from East and Texas. Ha ha ha.